getting into the final map. It's hyped. We have got the knife run coming right up. Of course, Train, you want to be on that CT side to start if you want to get that strong start. It looks like Envy should be winning this knife round. Ooh, it's actually pretty close, but nope, indeed Envy do pull through with it. And we will be seeing now Envy should stick to the CT side, you would expect. For some reason their coach has joined the team, he really wants to get involved. And indeed, Envy do stay on the CT side. So now it's going to be again all about the pistol round buys. We should be seeing someone pick up a kit on the Envy side. Generally, I think it's been Sixer who's been the more supportive player on the team, but quite often they've been going for the five Kevlars. Wow, okay, Happy picks up a Deagle. The Envy coach kind of struggling to get into the server here. There we go, I think he's got it sorted. So. Is Happy going to keep the Desert Eagle without Kevlar, or is he going to drop it over to Scream again? We saw Scream get the Deagle earlier. Oh, you can see, is that dead body going to be an issue? I don't know if their coach bought anything and then died. Like, if he bought a kit or something, then they might have to restart this. Oh. Okay, well, I have no clue what's just happened, but for some reason we're loading Dust Boys. Maybe they just decided, you know what, screw all these new fancy maps, let's just go back to the original Dust. I'm sure that's exactly what happened. So maybe the coach joined and then bought a kit and then died, like, and they have to reset the map. I don't really know. But now we're just stuck on the Dust loading screen. I mean, to be fair, we were on the Dust loading screen earlier, so. It should be fine. Hopefully it will fix itself. Hopefully we'll get into the map soon. And hopefully it will be Train, not Dust. Let's see. Yep, okay, so it is Train. So I guess for some reason they restarted the server. Maybe the coach joined and then left a kit on the ground or something. I don't know. But I guess we might be waiting a little longer. So I guess I'll just put it back on the music and we'll just wait. So it looks like we should be getting back into it soon. Okay, I guess for some reason Nico changed his name, so that's right. So we're just hoping that the coach Malik or whatever doesn't drop a kit or something this time. Like, I could only assume he joined and accidentally bought something and then died. That's the only explanation I can think of. I think Malikimba is Envy's coach. I think he's been their coach for the first two maps anyway. Yeah, dude, you enjoy that music? Enjoy the 10 seconds of that song? So I think finally after this reset, we should be good because Envy just had to win the knife round again there, and we will finally be getting into the pistol round for real this time. Remember, Envy took their map over on... What did they win? It was Dust 2, right? Yeah, they took Dust 2, 16-13. Then Heroic came back to win Mirage 16-7, their own map choice, with a solid victory. Really convincing stuff over on Mirage, and now we are getting into the final map here. Train being the decider, so... You know, if you base it off the first two map scores, you could say... hopefully that doesn't make a difference. Yeah, okay, good. So the coach has rejoined. You could say Heroic might be favourites here, you know, if you want to say that, because they won their map more convincingly. But of course, that's a bit too simplistic. That's not always how it is. We're going to see the push going towards outside. XMS needs to watch his back here. Sixer is there, and he's actually got help. And look at this. It's a complete shutdown. The pistol one-taps coming in all over from Envy. It's just Moddy versus the world. Moddy isn't quite Superman today. He gets taken down after only two kills. I mean, in a 1v5, two kills isn't too bad, all things considered, but not quite good enough to pull through and win them the round. So Envy getting off to a solid start on CT side train, and that's really what you need to go ahead and pick up that economy boost early on. If you can get that economy rolling, then on CT side train, you can really have a dominant CT side. So Nico's lining up a smoke here. Heroic, of course, not getting the bomb plant means that they're just going to force up with the techs. Because even if they do this, they will be full eco next round and then buying up with the AKs. Oh, there you go. I need to press escape again. We can see the health now. Woo. You can see on the Envy side, this is actually a lot of SMGs. The UMPs are very, like, really good against armor still, but it's pretty risky to only have 1 M4 in there. XMS might have to do a lot of work if this round does end up becoming close. You can see two players from Envy towards the B site. Sometimes you see only one with the rotator from Connector, but Happy is there to help out RPK as well. Smokes towards the B site from Heroic are a fake right now. It will be an A play. Scream, however, with the aggression, already picks up two headshots. He's looking for the third as well. He's completely shut down one half of this A push. He's going to go back for more. 12 bullets left still. He's looking for more kills, looking for both sides. Eventually picks up the third as well. And Snappy now has to try and win at 1v5 with a tech. And instantly gets punished by Scream. You know what, Scream? You got a lot of taps. We'll play it. We talk about your one tap, Scream. Four kills in the round for Scream. You know, that last USP shot, I think, settled it for me. That was a nice tap at the end there. As Envy pick up their second round, it looked like Heroic were going to have a pretty solid round, but Scream just completely shut down that A push. The B fake was going pretty well. But Scream's aggression just got info early on. And that will give Envy the round, so Heroic force onto full eco. You can see Envy just... Heroic just sort of trading guns at spawn, deciding who wants what. Eventually they figure it out. Meanwhile, Envy deciding to keep a lot of their SMGs again. Of course, I don't think anyone died last round. Yeah, no one died last round, so no need to buy up anything more. They know they're against pretty much a full eco from Heroic with just a couple of upgraded pistols. Breaking a few of the windows there, making a bit of noise at B. On the last round, they did fake the B site, so maybe they're thinking they can pretend it's a fake and then hit B anyway, and it will be a fake. Ultimate mind games. Looks like if that's what they're going for, Envy are not falling for it. There's still two players towards the B site here. Ooh, RPK's nade destroys Moddy. Moddy's down to 9 HP already. Four Heroic players are lining up towards upper, and it's just Snappy looking to come down ramp. 55 seconds left. Heroic still haven't made their move here. And slowly but surely, I think Heroic should be committing to this B site, although it looks like they've gone for a boost first. Nico is up there on top. I don't think he's going to be able to see anything over there. Indeed, he's not. 35 seconds left now, and Heroic are leaving it a bit late here. Nico's going to push out through upper with his Deagle. He's the only one that's got that Desert Eagle for the one-shot potential. However, it looks like it's just going to be a pretty easy hold from Envy. Indeed, four quick kills. It's all up to Cadian, and he does not get anything. So after all that waiting, Heroic get completely shut down on the B push. So maybe they were hoping Envy would get a bit confused by how long they were waiting, but we will have to... Well, it didn't work out if that's what they're going for. We can see now Envy have kept three of the UMPs here, so... I mean, this just shows how powerful the UMPs are, but Envy are willing to keep three of them on this gun round. Meanwhile, Heroic have the full AK, so you'd have to say Heroic, in terms of firepower, are still the favourites. I know the UMPs are good, but they're not quite the AKs. And we will be seeing Envy go for a bit of aggression towards A main early on there, so that's a nice little bit of info. It's Scream again with the UMP pushing towards A main. Could we be having flashbacks the last round here? Scream could take out Valdo, but he's not quite looking the right way. Oh my god, he doesn't get the kill. What is he doing looking into the wall? I think he was waiting for a flash, and it was just awkward timing. As now, Heroic would just explode on towards this A site and take it cleanly. Without a single player dropping, Valdo picks up another kill. And RPK, I mean, I guess he's going to go for it, but I don't fancy his chances. Indeed, taken down. Only Valdo taking damage on the round for Heroic, and not a single player lost on the Heroic side. So, I mean, Envy had three UMPs, so they must have been aware that was a possibility. And now they will bite up with more M4s. In fact, Sixer has the AWP as well, so... First AWP of train bought here. We'll have to see what Sixer decides to do with it. Sixer gonna go ahead and go for a bit of Ivy aggression. Just holding the angle for now. The flash comes through. He somehow avoids it. He could be getting an opening here. I think the players are boosted up, though. It looks like they jump boosted across, so... If Sixer's holding this angle, this could be an issue, because there's a player on the other side here, but the smoke going through is going to force Sixer off the angle anyway, I think, so doesn't matter too much in the end. But nice run boost from Heroic, just to get over to the other side safely. We've seen Sixer be the primary AWP on this, in this series so far, and he's done pretty well with it in general. On Dust 2, he had some important kills, but he hasn't really had it all that often. Still 1 minute 5 seconds left on the round for Heroic to make up their mind as to where they want to go. There's, I guess, has RPK got his gun out? RPK's gun is invisible, I guess? Alright then. The invisible gun gonna try and shoot some enemies holding this angle. You can see it looks like Heroic are not going towards this site though. They will be rushing out of pop over towards A, so no B push coming in. Valda already getting one entry. XMS trades one back, but he's up on top of Blue, very exposed from all angles. That allows Nico to easily take him down. Heroic get down to a 3v3 with some good trades on the A site take. And now they just have to play at post plant where they have to be favourites here. Bombs planted in a pretty open position. RPK going to push through. And again, Envy are going to have to push through eventually. The time is ticking down. And as soon as they do, you'd assume Heroic will just be sitting and waiting. RPK pushing through towards the site. Surely spots out the first. Indeed, does take down Snappy. He is aware that it could be Heaven as well. Indeed, Money's been taken down. And now it's all up to Nico in towards Pop. They line up for him. Oh, Nico sprays down two. He's looking for the third. Happy takes him down. Has he got time here? I think he does with the kit. It's going to be so close here. I think Happy should just get it. Oh, he does get it in the end. He actually picked up that defuse kit off of someone's body, so fair play to him for that. They do end up winning the round, and Envy now looking pretty solid here. Heroic will still have the buy. Nico, though, nearly clutching that through. The AK spray, wild spray down to take down two, but just doesn't quite win them the round. Kadian does have the AWP for Heroic on the T side now, and Sixer has the AWP for CT, so... We could be seeing some AWP battles going on here. This is the first AWP Kadian has had so far. We'll have to see if he can get anything done with it. Meanwhile, Envy deciding this time they're not going to go... Ooh, actually. Okay, so Envy are still playing just two at B, not one in connector. So, you know, I'd say the default setup is having one B, one connector for the quick rotate. Even if the connector player is already watching, it's that sort of thing. Can see Heroic are just taking their time lining up the B smokes here. Molly smoking out from upper, and this will be a B execute any second now. 1 minute 5 left on the clock. Not too many nades left from Envy as well, so this could be successful. You can see Nico getting the first entry. Molly's back there with the trade, and that's going to allow actually Heroic to take the advantage here. They have got the one man advantage. However, look at this Scream. How is Scream not spotting him towards site here? Surely they see each other. Finally, Nico is aware and Kadian takes him down. Valdis should be peeking out. Yeah, and Six is not aware. XMS 2 HP. Why is he even thinking of peeking out? Well, I guess that's why. He does get the kill, but with just 2 points of health. Yeah, I think you better run, bud. Although it looks like he's going to push back towards the site. Nico, can you not see him? There we go. Finally spots him out. What a weird round. It seemed like people were just looking at each other and not realizing it. Eventually, they do spot each other out. So that will be Heroic picking up their second round on this T side. And look at this. You know, the CT weaponry being more expensive means you can see here the money on Envy's side is really poor. They're gonna have to buy up with pistols now. It looks like they've got a few pistols together, but again, nothing spectacular. You can see again Scream, he does love his Desert Eagle, doesn't he? I mean, when you can get headshots like Scream, I guess it is worth it. It's a very quick A play here for Rogue. Yeah, they knew they were anti-eco. I don't think they'd do this. Already, some of them going down. Happy getting the long-range CZ kill. It looks like a complete shutdown here. Cadian's left, trying to clutch it with an AWP 1v3. The quick play not working out, and XMS takes him down in the end. And somehow, Envy win a round that they never should have won. The early A stack from Envy works out with the early B, with the early A rush from Heroic, sorry. And that will be Envy now, all of a sudden recovering, and Heroic being the ones that have a decision to make here. They will indeed go for the Force. You can see only one AK in there, so it's not the best Force, but I mean, Envy just won with full pistols, so who knows what could happen in this game. You can see here, Molly's going to try and be the one to take the first opening indeed. He's the only one with the AK, so he has to take those early fights. He does tag RPK down low and doesn't take any damage in return, so nice start for Heroic. They have got a few players grouped up towards the B site with a bomb as well. Meanwhile, I think it's Valder. No, not Valder. Who is it? There's one player lurking towards A. There it is. Cadian towards Ivy. However, he's not going to go for the fake too hard. The flashes and smokes that will go through. RPK going to be forced back. Although, having said that, he's not forced back at all. He just goes for the re-peek and the kill towards Moddy. If anyone knows how to fix RPK's invisible gun, by the way, hit me up, because that's starting to get annoying. Vada will be pushing through. Ooh, will pick up the AK. It's not quite going to be the B push yet from Heroic, so a bit of a weird round, really. Moddy trying to entry with the AK, then no one really follows him up. And now Heroic with just 40 seconds left. Again, they've just not been very decisive this round. It's all seemed a bit disjointed, the pushes around the map. So we can see with just 30 seconds left now, still quite a few smokes for Envy. Surely Heroic have to push sooner rather than later. Now it's just 20 seconds left now, as XMS will be pushing. A bit of aggression is going to work out well for him. The trades come in from his teammates, and Valder stuck in a 1v4. The Sixer punishes Valder at the end for peeking out a bit too wide. And again, Heroic just taking way too long there. As soon as Envy spot the players pushing towards that A site, they can completely gamble everyone towards there as soon as they see the bomb. As we will be seeing, Heroic force onto an eco now. So Envy CT side looking really solid here to start the half. Especially with Heroic being on Eco, they should be taking a 7-2 lead. Although we did see Envy win a pistol by themselves, so this could still go either way. Scream getting the opening kill. There's RPK with a Molotov kill on towards Molly, interestingly. Oh, they know the player's on site here. Snappy eventually taken down. Sixer, quite a couple of shots, but eventually he picks it up. XMS goes for the smoke. Valder and Cadian now. 2v5. They are going to go for the boost up, which I do like, but wow, this smoke is really solid. You can't even see anything through it. Looks like Happy's going to slowly go down the ladder. Are they watching? No, they're not. They both get mowed down. As Happy with the big luck plays comes through with two easy kills. That's going to be Envy, of course, as expected, picking up their 7th round. And now I believe this should be Heroic deciding to take the timeout after losing 3 in a row. They've probably got to discuss where the weaknesses are in Envy's setup. I think it's probably, you know, if I was going to say, I'd say the weaknesses are probably towards the A site from Envy. We see quite often Happy and RPK are both pretty committed towards B. So if you can get those entries towards A, it's going to be pretty scary for Envy. We saw the round, though, that Heroic like full-on rush day and Envy stacked it with a pistol, so maybe that's scaring them off. It's pretty difficult to decide for Heroic, but I think going for some sort of Ivy play might be a pretty good idea. We've seen Sixer over there with the AWP. He's not had too much to do so far. And again, I mean, Heroic, they also have to take into account what nades they have. They might not be able to do to fully pull off whatever executes they want to. You know, you can see they do have the five smokes, but they're kind of lacking in flashes. They only have the one Molotov on towards Valda, so it's not like they can just, you know, completely Molotov every spot in the trains. Go to RPK's view, escape. Will this fix it? Resume game, just click it. Rip, it's not worked. We'll just have RPK can just be the man with the invisible gun, it's fine. Looks like finally we will be getting the unpause in, so Heroic have made their decision, I guess. We'll have to see where they go and try and hit. We've seen, you know, Valde and Nico again, they've been performing pretty well, but the rest of the players just not really able to get anything done. You know, we saw the AWP invested in towards Cadian, and he couldn't really get any openings with it. He couldn't find the angles, so you know, that's pretty worrying if you're on the Heroic side. You see again, RPK is actually solo towards B for the start of the round. He will take a bit of early damage again. That is going to prompt Happy to rotate over. Looks like Heroic right now, sorry, have got three players towards Ivy, so you know, clearly listening to my strats. I'm the strat master, what can I say? Meanwhile, there's two players from Heroic towards Pop right now, so they could try and fake the B site if they wanted, or they could just go straight down the ladder. Either way, I think it's fine. You can see again with Envy having two players towards B, I really do think it's got to be best to try and commit through Ivy or A main or something like that. We can see Sixer does have the AWP on towards A, which could be scary, but still, the push will be coming through any second now. Scream just committing through the smoke. That's really risky. XMS does get the trade with the grenade there. Meanwhile, you can see the players lurking, but actually, wow, look at this. It's a heavy rotate from Envy, and Heroic have decided they don't have to commit towards this A site yet. They're going to try and get it back towards B. The bomb was pretty far away towards Ivy. And now, actually, okay, no, it is going to be an A play just through A main. So, Heroic with just 30 seconds left are coming towards the A site. And that has actually prompted Envy to rotate two players back towards B now. So, this could actually work out very well for Heroic here. The double mind game's working out. Moddy gets those two entries, and now Cadian should be getting the bomb down. He fakes it, and that allows Moddy to get another kill here. I keep thinking I should switch to Moddy, and then he just gets another kill before I can even manage it. So many entries for him there. Really making the difference in this round. As Happy now in a 1v4. I don't think he should even try going for this. You can see, I mean, Envy's economy is okay, sure, but no harm in saving an extra gun. Moddy somehow doesn't go down. He was really low already as he rounds the corner. Happy looking to see if he can pick up at least one kill here. Peeks out. Valda does get taken down. Looking for the second. That's Cadian with the AWP though, so Happy will just back off. And we will be seeing Happy save his gun on one side of the map, and the rest of Heroic saving their guns on the other side of the map here. So a nice little gentleman's agreement. You know, you go over there, we go over here. We'll just not talk to each other. You know, we'll just save our guns. Heroic, of course, going to be really happy to finally pick up that first round in a while for them. They lost three in a row before that, and we've seen the game be pretty back and forth so far. You know, neither team really stringing too many rounds together, so this is still up for grabs either way, especially considering how CT-sided training can be. Six has got the AWP again for Envy, as well as Cadian for Heroic, so again, pretty much full buys for both teams here. Heroic having slightly more nades, but not too much difference. It's only really Sixer who had to give up the nades. So we'll be seeing again Heroic of, I mean, we saw on their T sides on the earlier maps, they had some early aggression at some points. However, Heroic are playing very, very slow here on train. I guess maybe because it's so CT sided, they're scared of pushing through. I don't really know. Maybe they just don't have too many executes in mind. But still, it's looked like they've gone very slow throughout every round. And then as soon as Envy see the bomb towards the site with just 20 seconds left, obviously they can all just commit to the rotate fully. So I'd like to see maybe a bit of switch of pace from Heroic. I think it could catch Envy off guard. We saw them go for the A rush on that one round where Envy were eco, and they got punished for it against the pistols. But when you're against a full buy, that early aggression can definitely work out. I mean, you can see Envy are saving a lot of their nades for late on here. And that's going to allow them to, like, if Heroic push through, they're going to have a lot of nades to hold off any potential pushes. 25 seconds left now. Nico pushing through. Oh, bad timing for RPK. He just mollied that spot off, but Nico manages to get out on the edge of it. Here is Happy towards the B site, though. He drops down the bomb. 15 seconds left now, and all of a sudden, this is a very precarious spot for Heroic. They need to recover the bomb, and they need to get it fast. There's Nico picking up one. Make it two for Nico. I don't know if they have time to plant the bomb. Six are going aggressive. Is the bomb going down in time? Yes, it is, easily from Kadian. However, Sixer picks up another. He's looking to clutch the 1v3 here, and Kadian's so low on health. It looks like Sixer's not aware of that, though. He's going for the AWP right now. Just switches to the P250, but Kadian just about manages to pull through for Heroic to win the round. Such a close round in the end there. Sixer nearly having a big impact play there, but not quite able to win the 1v3. And that will be Heroic picking up a really big round for them, because now Envy are going to be on some sort of weird, awkward force buy. You can see here Kadian going for a bit of early aggression with the AWP, decides to just fall back. Envy have some pistols in there, as well as Scream on the UMP. See now again, Heroic going for the slow play against, you know, an eco or a sort of weird force buy that doesn't quite have the full weaponry. I definitely don't mind playing slow. You know, Envy might go for some aggression somewhere. You might be able to catch them off guard. You can see Heroic have saved a lot of their nades, and Envy have pretty much no grenades left in the tank. Happy does have the one flash, and that's about it. So again, it's Envy just going for their standard setup, which seems to be two towards B and then three towards A, with two of the A players sort of towards either. You can see here Sixer can go either way. Meanwhile, Heroic are slowly but surely coming to this B site, and already those two entries pretty much end the round. Heroic should be picking up their fifth T round here, and you can see Envy already have to think about what they want to try and do. XMS is in towards Connector, trying to maybe see if he can pick up an AK somewhere, but it's not looking good for Envy in this round, certainly. Maybe they just play for exits and try and see if some of the Heroic players overcommit, but again, the Heroic players can just exit as a group and then probably be pretty safe in saving their guns. You can see, however, somewhere else in the map, yeah, Sixer has already managed to pick up the first, so P250 doing well. However, there's Scream losing his UMP, and now Heroic have to get away from the bomb. They might take some damage here. Kadian does get the kill. You can see Nico's low on health. Will he survive? I think he should be out of range now. Yeah, just about gets away in time. And I think the last Envy player just died to the bomb. I think that's just what happened. But anyway, not too important there. I mean, as soon as they lost that B site, it was pretty much over for Envy, so Envy are going to have their buy now, and this is the round they've been waiting for. Having the full buy, this is a really big round for both teams, because if Envy win this one, they've done pretty well in the half. They'll bring back Heroic's economy pretty low. As you can see already, Happy picks up one and nearly takes down Kadian with the collateral. That was a really big AWP shot. The A rush from Heroic, again, I wanted them to change the pace up and go a bit faster, but maybe I was wrong, because it's really not worked out here. Two kills already for Envy very early on into the round. There's Nico at least trading one back. He's done very well with the AK so far this half, up there at 13 kills. However, it's not quite enough, because XMS takes down Moddy, and now Heroic is stuck in a 2v4, and again, it's just not looking good for them. They try to go for the A rush, it doesn't work, and it just seems like they're just not quite landing their shots here. Kadian finally returns one kill with the AWP, but in a 1v3 now, it's not looking good for him. Going to be forced to back off, but with 1 minute left in the round, very difficult to save that AWP, so he might have to go for a bit of aggression and see if he can pick up another kill. You can see Envy don't have much money themselves, so Envy might not be willing to commit to the hunt. We will have to wait and see what Envy decide. I think Envy should just save their guns. Heroic have a pretty solid economy built up. It doesn't matter too much if Kadian saves this, because Heroic are probably buying next round whatever happens. We will be seeing with 27 seconds left, Kadian still fully scoped in throughout the whole round. Still just walking away. It looks like you can see all of the Envy players are towards the A site, so no one's really going to be hunting down Kadian, so he should be safe for saving here. RPK thinking about going up the ladder maybe, but decides against it, and Cadian will be safe saving his AWP, so that's at least gonna help Herok's economy quite a lot. He can also drop one AK over. Herok aren't gonna have the best buy here though, all things considered. I thought their money was a bit better than it actually is. You can see here Cadian can drop the one AK over, so yeah, it's still full AKs and the AWP for Herok, so overall still a good buy. Meanwhile, Envy, I mean, their economy has really been dodgy throughout the whole game. They've never really been able to build it up on the CT side. I mean, with the weaponry being so important, that's understandable, but still, you've got to be able to build up your money there. You can see now the nade going in towards A main. Already, Cadian takes a bit of damage, but I thought it was more than 8, not gonna lie. It looked like it was closer than that, but only a little bit of damage done. Cadian, though, very aggressive with the AWP. That's scary. Doesn't quite get punished for it this time, however, he needs to be a bit more wary of those angles, I think. Just jumping across like that is pretty risky if any aggression comes through, especially when you don't have a teammate that near. We've got, again, Herok. It's almost like they're playing like Na'Vi from 2015 or something. Such slow play every round. The flash going through. Sixer sitting on the other side. That smoke was full blind, but Herok, of course, have no way of knowing he was there. Molly going off, and again, it's a pretty awkward take here now because they've mollied off the other side that they could have pushed through. You can see Scream's got this AK going for the tap, doesn't quite find it. The flash goes through, there's Nico again getting the entry. His AK has been impressive so far on T side, but it's not quite been enough for Herok to win that many rounds. See Happy trading one back, he's got the AWP. XMS gets another, and now Herok, it's not looking too good for them. A 2v3 is certainly doable though. Cadian's still got this AWP. And they know the positions of some of the Envy players. I think they know XMS is up on site, but Cadian doesn't quite react in time. And that's going to be Scream finishing it with a nice little tap to Moddy's head as Envy take a 9-5 lead. And now Herok forced onto just a buy with, what, Tech9s, a UMP in there. It's not looking all that good for them. So you would expect Envy to take a 10-5 half, which, I mean, for CT side on train, you know, it's definitely doable for Herok if they pick up 5 or 6 rounds T side. That's certainly a score you can come back from. Especially considering they lost the pistol round, that's a pretty solid half. We can see him Moddy trying to get an entry, but he doesn't quite find the angle at the right timing. You can see here there's actually two players towards B again from Envy, with also, I believe that is, yeah, Scream's in towards connector, so he can very quickly rotate over to B. So a B rush might not work out that well. It looks like Envy has some sort of read, maybe, that Herok are on low money. And of course, if Herok are on low money, they're more likely to rush B. It's a closer bomb site. It's much easier to get those close angles. You can see the smokes and flashes coming through. Now Happy, through the smoke, gets a bit of damage through. The nade, not quite enough to take down money. The flash is going through now. Valda picks up one. However, there are the trades coming in. Happy in the smoke. Oh, he whiffs a bit, but finally gets the P250 kill through. Moddy looking for a kill back, gets it. And all of a sudden, it's 2v2. However, Herok haven't been able to recover the guns that they took down. So that is a bit of an issue here. You can see Happy is pushed up towards upper. The bomb is on the B site. However, it's not been planted yet. There's Snappy recovering a gun for himself as well. So all of a sudden, in the 2v2, this is absolutely doable for Herok here. Moddy is low on health, but Six has taken a bit of damage too, so it's anyone's game right now, and it's just all down to the predictions. Let's see if Herok can do it. Well, there's Moddy taken down already. That's a bit of a shame that Snappy couldn't take the first fight. You can see he's going for a plant here. He doesn't quite know where the bombsite is. Finally fakes it, but Happy takes him down from behind, and that is Envy indeed taking their 10-round half. So very, very solid half for Envy here. Herok, though, we'll be pretty happy with 5 rounds. I don't think either team is too disappointed yet. It's certainly anyone's game, but I think Envy will be slightly happier of the two. As I'm sure we will be waiting for a bit in the halftime break. And unfortunately, of course, at halftime, the scores always break. Heading into the second half though, again, I mean, if Herok lose the pistol and the two subsequent rounds, then all of a sudden Envy could be up to a 13-5 lead, and from that point onwards, it's really difficult to come back into it. Just mentally, when you see the score being 13-5, it's already pretty damning. You feel like you're pretty far behind. We should be getting back into the second half any second now. The deciding map here on train. The all-important map. Again, we'll have to see. You know, the pistol round buys have been pretty interesting. Whenever anyone's gone for an upgraded pistol on the pistol round, we've seen a few Desert Eagles been picked up, which is interesting to say the least. They haven't really done all that much so far, but on the T side, I can certainly understand buying a Deagle for the one-shot headshot potential. We've seen it been dropped to Scream a few times. Happy's had it every now and then. Meanwhile, Heroic pretty much. You know, pretty standard pistol round buy as we've seen. You know, sometimes they will go pretty heavily on the utility. They will go for quite a few nades, but it's always seems to be, you know, a couple of players buying Kevlar and then maybe one or two being the supportive utility player picking up some grenades. Guessing both teams are just, you know, talking it over here maybe. Someone needs a toilet or something. We've got plenty of time, you know. It's an important game. We want both teams to be at their 100% best heading into the final half of the final map. You know, pretty important for both teams to qualify. So, absolutely, if they need a little break, we will certainly allow it, of course. Cadian, USP, go on. XMS with the big 180. Cadian struggling with the ESP there. What a nice little shot from XMS there. XMS has been pretty impressive so far, I think. You know, I'm sure, like others, you might not have heard a lot from him, but so far I think he's definitely held his own in this series. You know, it's not like he's ever been really far behind or anything. We can see. Ooh, okay, so Envy this time, the Tech-9 will be bought up by XMS. They've got the one smoke. Six are also buying a second smoke. Meanwhile, Heroic do have the kit on towards Cadian. So we'll have to wait and see where those smokes are planned to go. It looks like Envy are indeed going towards the B site. I kind of expected this. You can easily smoke down ramp and get a bomb plant, so certainly understandable why they want to go towards the B site. And you can see here the players are pretty grouped towards B. It's only Happy who's off on his lurk, which is pretty normal. XMS now is lining up one smoke for connector, I believe. Have to wait and see. There's one smoke for site and one smoke for connector, so that's nice. The smoke's going through as the flash goes over the top as well. Now the B play will be coming in. The push going through. Already six are picking up that opening. Heroic were playing very far back and pretty much giving up the site. You can see Valda playing on the edge of the smoke. A little bit of a one-way there allows him to get a free kill. There's Valda picking up a second as well. Modi gets another on the retake, and all of a sudden, after Envy take the site, they cannot hold it well enough at all. You can see Happy is trying to go for the lurk, but whenever Happy is the last alive, you can be pretty sure he is going to be lurking, and out of nowhere, Modi expects it, and Heroic, despite playing very passively on the B site, they're willing to give it up because they're confident in their retake, and it works out for them. As Heroic now have got a really good chance in this game, and I'm pretty happy to see Heroic win the pistol round, honestly, because now we could have a very close game on our hands, which could be pretty exciting. We will be seeing Heroic go for two rifles in there, three SMGs. You can see Envy, at least they got the bomb plants, so they will be buying a couple of pistols. No Kevlar though, so they will be saving for the buy round next round, of course. We'll have to see if they can get anything done on this B rush again. You can see two players towards the B site again for Heroic. However, it's quite easy to get the bomb planted, so there's Nico going for a bit of early info, that's nice. The B rush should be coming in any second, although the Molotov will slow it down. All of a sudden, Heroic have three players towards B. The nade goes through. That's a lot of damage towards Sixer, who's pushing out with just a Glock only. And it should be a pretty easy shutdown here. Indeed, it is. Easy as you like for Heroic. Only Cadian taking any damage. He just took 22 damage. That was all Envy could do without buy. So they won't quite get the bomb plant. However, Envy, with the bomb plant from the pistol round at least, not the second round, but the bomb plant from the pistol allows them to have enough money to buy up here. They have got the 5 AKs, which is nice, but I think I would have liked to see someone take the hit and downgrade to a Galil or maybe a Scout and make sure they at least have one player on full nades. As we will be seeing the flashes coming through, a bit of Ivy aggression attempted there. Meanwhile, Kanian in towards Pop. The UMP doing damage there as he picks up Happy very early on in the round. Happy will be disappointed with that one. The Pop flash from Kanian working out very well. He manages to recover the UMP and get the hell out of there. RPK was looking for the trade, but just couldn't quite get down the ladder quick enough. So we'll be seeing RPK. Is he just going to walk out through the smoke? If he gets the timing right, that would be pretty nuts, but... you know, you're relying on luck quite a lot. I think Kadian is just watching that smoke. Oh no, he's not. He's gone towards heaven. RPK is just sitting in the smoke, and look at this. He will just walk out just as it fades and get the easy kill. Moddy picks up two towards Ivy, though, so Heroic do retain a one-man advantage. So we'll be seeing Sixer and RPK in a 2v3 now. These players certainly capable of clutching it through for Envy. Both very experienced. Going back to 1.6 days, it's RPK with the AK. Just about going to find the kill. Brings it back to a 2v2. The bomb has been planted successfully. However, there's Moddy with his third of the round. Trying to do what he can. There's Sixer, though, getting a free kill on towards Valder, who had his back turned. And now, Moddy does know where Sixer is. He has to get the 4k to clutch it here. Sixer peeks out though, and Sixer takes him down. Finally, Sixer stepping up, clutching out the round for Envy. So nice 2 versus 3, 1 from Envy there. Pretty interesting that Heroic let them plant the bomb. I guess maybe they thought that the bomb planter would try and fake plant it to bait them out. But at the end of the day, yeah, they pull through and do well. Yeah, sorry, I'm trying to ban the guys, but I have to like alt-tab and it makes the stream lag. We've got MV still going for the buy here, but because they only saved the one gun from last round, it's a pretty awkward buy on their side. You can see Scream is down to just the Desert Eagle. But again, I mean, Scream with a Deke, you know, it's not always too bad. We've seen him hit some pretty nuts Deke shots in the first two maps. It will be Envy this time, going for a bit of a slow play. They've got three towards Ivy right now, and the other two players are somewhat towards the A site as well. You can see, I believe there's a player, yeah, RBK up here towards Pop. So the smoke's going through. A bit of an awkward smoke there. That's not probably where it was meant to be popped. However, the trades go through, and Envy take the one-man advantage from that. Good entries there. Snappy trades one back. He's looking for a second. Up on green train, though. He's very exposed from all angles. You can see he was forced to drop down. Meanwhile, Nico from Connector pushes through for a kill. Nico and Snappy could be winning a 2v3 of their own here as Nico pushes through and gets another from Connector. I didn't expect him to go aggressive, but he manages to pull it off, and it's again up to Sixer to try and clutch it. Spots out the first player, does good damage. Now both players are somewhat low, but it's still going to be difficult for him. It's not like one bullet will take them down. You can see Sixer trying to just dance around the bomb train here, see what he can do. Nico's on the other side of that smoke. He sprays. Oh my god, he nearly gets the kill. He's going for it still. Oh my god, Nico's so low, but unfortunately Sixer somehow can't find that one more bullet he needed. If he got that kill towards Nico, all of a sudden he's probably favourite to win the round, but a bit unfortunate there for Sixer. He's not able to find a single frag. Alright, we can time out this other guy now. There we go. Boom. Chat should be fine now. So, Sixer nearly able to get the one through the smoke. Doesn't quite manage it, but unfortunately for Envy, that does mean they are forced down to just pistols now. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Heroic putting some rounds together and putting Envy, you know, in the danger zone, if you like. Because Envy down onto an eco again, and with train being so CT-sided, Heroic might even be favourites at this point. Especially considering they, well, I thought they had the money built up, but actually, despite winning a few rounds, Heroic have pretty much no money on their side. So this round is pretty important that they retain as many guns as possible. You can see Scream full blinded there, unfortunately. He's not going to be able to find an opening with the Desert Eagle just yet. Another smoke goes down. Happy does some damage, but takes more in return. So with 1 minute left on the clock, Envy do have to make a decision somewhat soon, but they still have a bit of time. Again, they have forced up with the army. You can see they pretty much went for a full force here, so That's risky, but I think they know Herc's economy is low here. You can see again RPK trying to lurk out this smoke, just walk straight through it. There's Sixer getting one entry with the tech. He's looking for the second. He might pick it up as well. Moddy not looking the right way. Sixers all of a sudden making big impact plays here on the T side. Two entries. However, look at how low all of the MV players are. Already Happy gets taken down. RPK dinks one through. A lot of players low on both sides here. This is so awkward. Kadian's been dinked down. However, you can see Envy have what? 30 HP between them all. Scream is taking the bomb to B though, so Snappy now has to try and clutch it 1v2, but he's not even close to the right site. So we can see Snappy will be rotating, he's aware it's B. And actually, if he takes down Scream early on here, it could be all over. Sixer wasn't quite rotated over yet, however, Scream plays it smart, plays it safe. And now Snappy has it all to do. He does at least have the incendiary. That will go towards upper. Is he just going to be willing to stick it? The incendiary hasn't quite landed in the right spot. He taps the bomb. Sixer has to peek, spots out the bomb, and manages to get back in time. That's big from Sixer to get the info there, because now Snappy is really going to struggle. You can see Sixer running out again, just playing with Snappy. Snappy gets the one, but Screamy is there for the trade. Very well played by Envy there. They keep their cool. They manage to clutch it through in the end. Scream, you know, realizing the last player towards A, just takes the bomb to B. Cool as you like. And that allows the round win for Envy on a round they really never should have won, with just pistols on their side. They go for the force, they risk it. And that could be the big round to make the difference in this one. Because you can see now Herc are pretty low on money. They are kind of in trouble here. They could go for the force, but I don't think they will here. They've taken the pause, so they have time to discuss what will be the best option. I think the best option would just be pretty much a full eco on this round. Sure, you are conceding the 13th round to Envy, but you know, you've got to be confident in your buy rounds. And if they are confident in their buy rounds, then they should just eco this one. Because you should be able to win most of the time on CT side of train. We will be seeing again, these tactical pauses have been pretty long so far. And it looks like, well, contrary to what I was hoping for, Valda has already bought up here, so it will be a force from Herc. This is very, very risky now. This round is so important for Herc. If they lose this, I think it's pretty much over, to be honest. Envy, of course, also get to discuss during this tactical timeout that Herc have taken, so they might be thinking to themselves that Herc could force up, considering Herc have called for the timeout. So I think Envy will be aware that there's a possible force here, and I think they should just sit back and wait to see if there's any early aggression from the Herc side. You can see the unpause has come in, and we will be getting right back into the action here. Envy with the 4-round lead, but this is by no means over just yet. Herc have to win this force, though, if they want a really good chance here. Early on in the round, Moddy with a scout, spots out an opponent, can't quite find the tag, just not quite reacting in time to get the shot through there. That would have been a very nice opening to the round. You can see here though, Moddy towards Ivy now, again just not quite landing the shots. He's getting the opportunities to get some damage in early on, but just not quite landing with the scout. And look at that, Happy through the smoke with a big spray down on towards Kadian. Nice entry for Envy there, a bit of luck. But at the end of the day, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. And Happy decided to shoot through the smoke, and it worked out for him. Moddy has rotated over towards B with the scout. However, I don't know if he'll be able to stop this push all alone. He has got he has got Nico with him on the site with the UMP, so it's doable having the two players towards B. And as well, Valdi's got another kill elsewhere. In fact, look at this. They're actually flanking them here. They're getting pinched from both sides here, Envy. This could be a bit of an issue. However, that kill is going to be pretty important. They are going to go down towards the A site. And Valda had pushed out here, so Sixer can just walk on through, clean as you like, cool as you like, to get the bomb down. A bit of an oversight from Herc there. The one player towards ladder goes down, and that allows the free bomb plant. However, RPK not aware. There's a player towards the top of Pop. Ends up picking up an easy kill. Moddy will be peeking towards Ivy, but again, no one there. It will just be the two Envy players now trying to hold it off here. The tap towards the bomb. Sixer manages to get one in reply, and it looks like Valda, thinking about sticking it, taps the bomb. Sixer's forced to run out through the smoke, and look at this! Herc out of nowhere do manage to win the 2v2. I thought Envy were in the really good positions to hold the bomb, but Sixer was kind of stuck in the smoke. He had to run out of it. That allowed an easy kill for Valda. And Moddy found the headshot in the meantime, and despite both Heroic players ending low on health, they managed to win a big round there. And that, all of a sudden, makes this game very, very competitive indeed. I really thought that Envy had that one pretty sewn up. I mean, sure, it was a 2v3, but they had the weaponry advantage. The bomb was planted in a pretty good spot for them. We'll have to see now. Envy have decided to go for the eco, which I do like, especially considering they have the pretty big lead. It's understandable. You can see their money here. They should be able to buy after just one eco round. And look at that. Oh, that is always so frustrating. XMS taken down to 14 health before the round has even really begun. He doesn't even see an enemy, and the grenade takes him down low. We will be seeing again Envy going for their slow style. So it seems like both teams going very slow on the T side. Just, you know, play it slow. Make sure you clear out every angle. Be methodical on your pushes. I like it. However, on this round, Envy haven't got too many nades and stuff to be methodical with. It looks like Scream will have spotted out Cadian up on towards Green Train there and didn't quite land the deagle shot. But that's at least a little bit of information for Envy. Push is coming towards this A site slowly but surely. However, again, it's not really that much of a group push. You can see Cadian wild spray down eventually finds the kill. And it has been a shutdown on the A site as expected in this round, as Happy does get finished off. Cadian does somehow manage to get three kills in the end. It wasn't pretty from Cadian, but at the end of the day, he found the frags, and that is what is important, as Envy don't get a single kill on their Felico. And now we will be seeing Envy on a buy. It's not the best buy in the world, but it's not too bad. They have got the Galil towards XMS. They have got decent utility, so I wouldn't be too surprised to see Envy pull off this round win, but Heroic definitely have the better weaponry on their side. Nico's decided to stick with the UMP, which I'm not really a fan of. You know, they would have had money for a proper rifle if they wanted to. Haven't really talked about Heroic CT side setup too much so far. They have got the two players towards B pretty committed to the bombsite as well. Early on, no damage done just yet with 1 minute 18 left into the round. Both teams playing very passively to start it off. Envy have got three players towards Ivy. It seems like this is just the default setup from both teams. The push is coming through slowly but surely towards Ivy though. You can see his Scream will go for the smoke off. There is a player up towards green or blue train, I believe. Will they be able to spot him out? Indeed they do. There's a trade from XMS. He takes down Valdo, who's playing up on the trains. Happy goes for a spam here. I don't really like that. That's just giving up his position, but somehow manages to spam Moddy low. I don't know how he pulled that off. Snappy New, meanwhile, from Heaven has got a really good spot to watch at least one kill, but gets traded on. And now it's a 3 versus 3. However, this has to be advantage Envy, especially with that kill coming through. They've got the bomb down. Sixer! How does he do that damage through the smoke? Flicks over there somehow. And now Cadian and Moddy have to try and clutch it 2 versus 3. We've seen a couple of 2v3s won in this game so far. Cadian peeks out, gets taken down. And now Moddy on just 19 health. He's probably just going to have to save here. So Envy win a really important round for them. You can see Moddy will just fall back to save the gun. So Envy, it was a very chaotic round, a very chaotic push on towards that A site. However, they do manage to come out on top in the end. The bomb does go off. Moddy will be able to save again. Both teams just saving on opposite sides of the map. And now we will be seeing Heroic are going for the buy, so it's not all bad for Heroic. They've still got the money for the buy here. And you can see the money on Envy's side isn't great either. It's only Happy's got really any meaningful money in the bank. Also, Heroic have the AWP on their side on towards Cadian. Could that be the difference? With Envy just having the 5 AKs, Cadian could try and take some long-range engagements, and maybe that could make the difference here. You can see again, this time Envy also having three players towards Ivy, so this is definitely their default setup. We've seen it round after round. However, ooh, a bit of over-aggression from Happy, and he nearly gets punished for it there. Cadian gets the opportunity to get the opening frag. Doesn't quite land the shot this time. Meanwhile, the rest of Envy Despite their default having three players towards Ivy, they are now slowly but surely making their way towards B. So, with so many players towards this B site from Envy, it was very likely to be a B push, you would assume. There we go, Nico spots them out. He's the only player towards B right now, and the rotate is not going to come in quickly. Surely Envy have this round pretty much in the bag, because look at this. All the heroic players on the map right now are all towards the A site. Ignore the circle. Everyone's towards A for heroic, and now they have to make a decision as to whether or not they think they can win this round. Risky, risky stuff from Heroic there, committing so many players towards the A site, and they get punished for it. The quick push through the Molly from Envy will work out, and look at this. Indeed, just one kill in the round is enough for Heroic to say, you know what, we're just going to save over here. The B site completely taken, and it's almost impossible to retake. Envy will take their 14th round off of just one entry on the B site. The gamble from Heroic does not pay off this time. As Heroic, having such low money, they decide they have to just save their guns for the next round, and it's putting a lot of pressure on their future rounds. Happy with a bit of over-aggression there. Snappy just had a UMP, and now he's going to be able to save an AK. So, again, I don't like that from Happy. There's no one near him to help him trade. He doesn't need to push through there. Instead now, they save an AK instead of the UMP, but still, Envy will have a solid buy, Heroic will have a solid buy, so basically, Envy just got a round for free there. And we will be seeing Heroic have a really solid buy again here. They've got pretty much full nades, full kits on their side, so again, despite losing another round, they still have a very good buy. So it's not all over for Heroic just yet, especially on the CT side of train. See again, Envy with the three players towards Ivy at the start of the round, and again, look on the map here. Again, Heroic have just one player towards the B site. Again, a massive gamble. Like, I don't know if I like this setup from Heroic. You've got to at least have a player in towards Connector to get ready for the rotate if necessary. Modi goes for a bit of a pre-fire there, a bit antsy maybe, in heading into the final rounds. You've got to be a bit nervous when you head towards these final few rounds. They're so much more important here. We'll be seeing Valor taking the opening duel, RPK taken low, a couple of the Envy players actually taking a fair bit of damage early on into the round. Modi putting that smoke up, I don't know if that benefits him. Like, Screamy could just walk through that towards the other side. Already though, how has Sixer got to that position? Gets a free call towards Valor, Sixer gets another here. He's making massive impact on the round right now as he gets two entries. RPK looking for the trade on towards Snappy. He knows his position, peeks out at the right time. It's looking good for Envy right now as there's Nico taken down, and Kaden has to try and clutch at 1v3, and the AWP is not the best weapon to do so. He spots the cross towards site, but he gets flanked by Happy, and Envy are looking good to take it through here. 15-10 lead, Heroic on a pretty poor buy. Envy with just the 5 AKs, but that's all they need here. They don't need the AWP. And it will be, meanwhile, Heroic. Of course, they have to spend all their money. Kadian had a bit of money left there, decided to buy right at the end, and went for the Mag 7. But you can see it's not the best buy from Heroic. They don't even have a single proper rifle on their side, only the Scout, which you can kind of count. I mean, it's a sniper rifle, you know. Already, though, Nico with a push. Look at this. It's a very aggressive A push. Or, sorry, B push from Heroic, and they do manage to recover a few guns from it. All of a sudden, quickly a 2v2. Make it a 2v1. They've lost the bomb as well. And all of a sudden, quick aggression from Heroic, making the difference as Happy runs up, gets caught out, and out of nowhere, Heroic win a round that they probably shouldn't have won, but they will absolutely take it here. However, again, Heroic's money's still not great after winning that round. I think Heroic will just be happy they are still in the game, though. Envy getting punished with that early aggression. Weren't quite expecting it, and look at this. Envy have decided to go for the force themselves. However, you can see it's not a very solid buy between them either. It's not consistent in terms of what each player has. You can see a couple of rifles in there, but then Sixer and XMS falls down onto the pistols. Nico goes for aggression. Nico gets three! Sure, Sixer gets the trade, but who the hell cares? Nico is very happy to spray down three. That's where that unsilenced M4 comes in handy. Valda going to push through to the flank as well. Does he spot out Sixer? Eventually he does. And it's again Happy trying to clutch it 1v3. So often he's left in these positions, but I don't think he's going to be able to get it done this time. He's pushing through, looking for the first kill. Gets the first, but there's Valder for the trade. And Nico's aggression towards Ramp again picks him up three kills and makes the difference for Heroic to win the round. As now it's Envy's turn to take the timeout. We will be seeing here Envy have kind of a decision to make. They probably should just go for sort of a Tech Knight armor buy, something like that. Yeah, scoreboard is bugged. I'm pretty sure Scream is... I think Scream's doing pretty well right now. He definitely doesn't have two kills. We've got Envy still talking it out. I'm guessing it was them who chose to take this timeout. They do have a decision to make here. They could have four AKs if they wanted to, but they would definitely be lacking on the grenades. So I prefer to see, you know, just some sort of pistol armor buys going through. Meanwhile, on the Heroic side, they've already got the four rifles. Cadian still has to buy, I believe. Yeah, he's still got money. And we will be seeing Envy do make their decision here. Scream can afford the AK just about. He's not got much money left behind, but hey, if he's feeling confident with it, fair enough. Why not go for it? Envy with the map points still. They've got three map points here, three series points here. But going to be pretty difficult to close them out on a buy like this. You can see only really Scream having the armor, having the nades, having the gun. They're going to rely on him to get the entry. They're going with three towards Ivy again. The default setup for them so far. It looks like they're going to send in some cannon fodder first with the players having the pistols, and then maybe Scream can get the trades. You can see he's just standing behind, waiting for XMS to push through. So I like that decision, you know, let Scream get the trades through. And then maybe you can recover some of the guns. Again, though, I really don't, like, I keep saying it, but I really don't like that Heroic's default setup has so many players coming in towards A. It just feels like any B rush from Envy that gets the first kill, you know, ends the round. It's so risky. So far though, Envy have not rushed the B site too often, so I guess it's not too bad of a decision. You can see already Valda getting the first opening. XMS with a P250 manages to get a kill. That's quite surprising. Scream does manage to get at least one headshot, but now he's taken down very, very low with the AK. Just 6 HP for him, as well as 9 HP for Sixto. So sure, it's a 3v3, but with two players on Envy so low, very difficult for them to win the round. And with Happy being taken down now, this one should pretty much be over. One shot to kill either of these players. Valda decides to go for a bit of an overkill there. The headshot onto the player with just 9 HP completely decapitates him. A Scream has to try and clutch it 1v3. Could get a 1v1 fight there, but doesn't quite manage to win it. If he takes down that first, there's a chance to win it through, but unfortunately, he can't win the first duel, and that means Envy now, again, because of how much they bought into last round, they again have a decision to make here. I really don't like how much they committed to the buy last round, because now you can see they are going for a force, but it's not a great buy again. I think Envy are kind of throwing away their advantage here. Round by round, they are just, you know, why not just save for one solid buy? Instead, you're having like three kind of sort of good buys, but not actually that good. I mean, you can see the nades on the Envy side, it's just not really good enough. Six are unhappy having none whatsoever. You can see again Envy going for a pretty slow start to the round. However, this time they've got three players sitting and watching that B push rather than three towards Ivy. So a slight change to their default setup, but not too much different. I think, yeah, Scream just did just take 10 damage from that spam there. Not too important in the round, but I guess now an M4 dink would instantly kill Scream. So hey, maybe that could make a big difference in the round. You never know. Small things like that sometimes can make big differences in the round. We can see Envy are going for this B rush. However, this time Heroic have changed it up a bit. They've got two players towards B. This could be pretty brutal. The spray down from Moddy gets two Nikos there to trade back as well. Sixer sure gets one trade back from upper, but Moddy's there to get another kill. And again, Happy on the lurk. When the execute doesn't go well like that, Happy's just stuck twiddling his thumbs, basically. He's got nothing to do in the round now, 1 versus 4. The bomb's stuck towards the B site. All of the heroic players are over there, just sitting on it. And Happy now with 25 seconds left. He is, you know, slowly but surely pushing up, but he might just want to think about saving this AK, considering the money on Envy's side. Envy are going to have to buy next round whatever happens, because you can see it will be the last round in regulation. 15-13 currently. Happy not going for the round win, just going for a bit of damage. Does take down Snappy. Heroic don't exactly have the best money, so taking a few guns off them wouldn't be the worst idea in the world. However, now Happy needs to make sure he doesn't die after time. Indeed, we'll back off. And well, it's all up to this, ladies and gentlemen. If Envy win this round, they will go through. However, if Heroic win it, we could be going to overtime. And I mean, considering Envy had, what, a 15-10 lead? For Heroic to win 5 in a row would be pretty impressive. We will be seeing not a great buy from Envy again here. You know, I'm just disappointed with how Envy dealt with this. I feel like they should have saved for a full gun round. Instead, now they've got a couple of Galils in this round, a tech in there. They never really gave themselves an opportunity to push through with a full gun round, to push through with a full execute. And that could come back to bite them here. Smoke going off towards Ivy. Early on, again, Envy very spread out, just waiting for pushes. However, Heroic haven't really been going for any early aggression. They haven't really needed to. They've had a pretty strong CT side so far. Cadian this time is in towards connector for the quick rotate to B, which I do like. You can see, though, Envy seem to be slowly but surely creeping their way up towards the A site right now. Two players towards Ivy. That's a bit of sound that Moddy will hear there. XMS getting off of the boost. Nearly gets punished for it with a spray through. However, 48 seconds left now, and Envy do have to make a decision pretty soon here in the final round of regulation. Who will get the first kill in this all-important round? 34 seconds left now. Envy taking all the time in the world here. Not even peeking out yet. Finally, Valda takes the opening duel. He wins it against RPK early on. He's going for more here. Snappy in the meantime's got one. Valda gets another. And it's looking like it could all be over for Envy here. We could be going to overtime. It's Happy 1 versus 3. He's going to pre-fire the corner. Does get the first, but takes a lot of damage in the process. Happy with just 13 seconds left. Has to push towards the site right now. He's going to try and get the first kill, but punished by Nico, who's going to say, you know what? Let's go to an overtime. Let's make it exciting. And we will be going to overtime, ladies and gentlemen. This could get interesting. You know, Envy got to be a little bit disappointed whenever you're, you know, 15-10 up and you end up going to overtime. You're always going to be pretty disappointed. However, Envy can't be thinking about that now. They have to just look onwards to the overtime. They have to make sure that they are fully focused on the coming rounds. It looks like Envy will start on the T side for overtime, so you know, that doesn't really help them considering they just lost the last 5 rounds on T side. However, because it's overtime, they will at least have full buys, which is nice. And again, I think both teams will just take a bit of a break, take their time. You know, again, when it's overtime, you know, it's fair enough. They've already been playing a lot of CS. Heroic already played 2 maps against Epsilon before this, and they've played some pretty long maps against Envy here, so absolutely fair enough to go ahead and just, you know, just chill out. And we want, of course, the best CS possible for overtime here. So both teams just going to make sure they, you know, take their time. Maybe get a bit refreshed. Heading into overtime. I mean, I guess we play the one taps thing for that, right? Scream did a lot of one taps.
They talk about my one tap. They talk about my one tap.
I mean, it was on a bunch of AFK players. It was basically aimbots, but you know, shh, don't tell anyone. We'll be right back. Again, looks like Heroic are just pretty much AFK, so I'm sure we'll get back into it soon. Just waiting on the players to be ready here. And indeed, finally, they are ready for overtime. They've got 10k behind. I think it's MR3 overtime, so should be first to 19 in this first overtime. And we'll have to see who buys the orbs. There we go. Look, are the scores fixed? No, they're not. Never mind. I thought for a second the scores are fixed, but they're not. As we get into overtime, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to get pretty tense right now. Cadian and Sixer both having the orbs. Both primary AWPers having the orbs for their team. Both investing pretty heavily. See Garda going for a bit of a spam. Can't quite find it. And again, as we've seen a lot early on in the rounds, no aggression whatsoever from either team so far. Very passive stuff from both of them. We've seen this a lot of waiting towards the start of the round from Envy. This time though, Cadian switching it up. Finally, someone goes for a bit of aggression. However, Cadian gets punished for it. Happy already picking up one. Goes a bit over aggressive, I believe, there. Nearly gets punished for it. Taken down very low. So after Envy get the opening, all of a sudden they lose two players. Moddy's nade does land on towards Happy, and now Valda has a lot to do here. He picks up the first, looking for a second, dancing around E-box, but no, Scream takes him down. Scream actually gets two kills in there. Sixer gets an AWP kill, and now Nico has to try and clutch it. He's been pretty impressive so far throughout this series, but a 1v2 is always difficult to pull off. He's trying to get towards E-box. He has the bomb in his possession. There's a player on top of Green, but he doesn't spot out Sixer there, so now Nico could actually get a free kill here. He does. Scream taken down instantly with a headshot. Sixer does spot him out, and oh! Nico commits a bit too much on top of that ladder. And that will be Sixer. I mean, I would like to have seen that from his POV, because that must have been a very tight shot, but he picks it up. And Envy finally pick up a T-side round here. We will be seeing Heroic again. If they lose this, they are on very low money. It could all be over. However, they've got a very solid buy for this round. We can see again Envy going for their classic slow setup. Heroic this time, there we go. They've got a man in towards connector, so they are ready to rotate over towards the B site. I like that Valdir is here. You know, having one player towards B is just so risky, as I've been saying. As soon as he dies, it's pretty much game over, so Heroic deciding to adapt a bit, changing in between rounds depending on what sort of read they have. Sixer with a nice boost over the smoke. I don't think he's going to get anything from it, but, you know, good idea from Envy. Shows that they've got at least, you know, some team play together. Molly's going off, Scream force back, a bit of damage both ways. Here's the flash into A main, but look at that! Sixer up close and personal with the AWP, does manage to find the opening frag. Good entry for Envy again here, and this could be disaster for Heroic if they lose this round. Snappy on towards the site, trying to spot out an opponent. He's still trying to get the tap, finally finds the headshot, but gets blinded up. There's Happy with the lurk towards Ivy, already getting one. There are players on towards the site from Heroic willing to hold it. However, Scream taps off ahead. There's Cadian with one trade back. The AWP on towards site gets another. Can he win this now? One versus two. Envy decide to slow it down, but the bomb is nowhere near here. They're going to have to push through and commit to the kill maybe with 34 seconds left in the round. The bomb's all the way back towards A main right now. They will go back to try and get it, but Cadian with an ill-advised peek. Sixer says, no thank you sir, my AWP is better than yours. I've got the Dragon Lore, baby. And that will be Envy taking their second round, and all of a sudden Heroic are forced onto an awful buy. What a round for Envy to pick up. Sixer with two big impact kills. He gets the first kill for them in the class, and he gets the last kill for them in the class? In the round. Gets the first kill for them in the round, and the last kill for them in the round. And we see now Heroic have it all to do with a pretty awful buy. Snappy goes for a bit of aggression towards Pop. They go for the B rush again. Sixer's watching it this time. XMS gets one. Scream gets one as well. And now Nico and Moddy are in an awful spot here. See, Moddy does get the tag on towards Happy. Happy forced to go back passively. Nico spraying through, does take down the bomb. There's Moddy getting one of his own. Nico looking to see if he can pick up more here. They all push through. That's risky, but it does just about work out this time. You can see Moddy going for the rotate. Doesn't quite land the first shot. And RPK is there for the trade. So Envy pick up the first three rounds of overtime. And now they just need to pick up a single round on the CT side here. They've got three chances to do it. and surely Envy have to be massive favourites to take this map and indeed the entire series now. At least Heroic, of course, heading into the second half, will have money again. And if they win two in a row, Envy might be forced onto an eco spot, so it's certainly doable for Heroic. They can't give up yet, of course. However, for this to even go to overtime, I think Heroic will be happy with. Now we have to wait and see if they can pull through with it. I mean, again, it's Heroic again. We saw them down, what, 15-10 earlier on, and they managed to pull it back for an overtime. You know, 18-15 is nothing. That's just a three-round deficit. That's easy. Ooh, just before the end there, Moddy gets a tap. As we will be heading into the second half of overtime now. Let's see if Heroic can pull it off. We've got Cadian on the AWP. Has Sixer decided to go for one yet? He's still making up his mind. He's not got the best spawn here. Does decide to go for the AWP though. Of course, with so much money, you might as well just go for it. As we will be getting into what could be the final round of the series here. Envy with a three-round lead. With three map points. But they did have five map points earlier, and they didn't manage to convert any of them. Valda though already naded down. I guess Sixer managed to nade him through the smoke. I didn't quite see that. Maybe he got a leg shot through as well, but big entry for Envy on the round. In a round that Heroic need to win, Valda getting killed so early without probably seeing an opponent. Got to be irritating for them. However, look at this. They are changing up the pace. I like this. After a lot of slow rounds, Heroic finally speeding it up on towards this A push. Scream on the site. Ooh, gets taken down thanks to that jump. X-Men's gonna push through the smoke. This is ballsy. And it works out for him. Cadian taken down very low. XMS still going for the aggression. Fights happening all over the map. A very sloppy round. However, look at this. The retake from Heroic is somehow working. They managed to pick up three kills out of nowhere. And now Sixer has to try and defend... Oh, sorry. Retake the site. One versus four. And Heroic do very well to take the site there. Sixer. Ooh, he gets the first. He was trying to go for a sneaky, sneaky play. He doesn't even have the kit, though. Now he picks up the kit, but it's too little too late. He does at least get the second kill. He's looking for more here. Can he do this? Sixer running out of time. I don't think it's going to be possible, and indeed, he doesn't either. He's going to be forced to save. So Heroic, out of nowhere, a flurry of frags. Pick up three kills in quick succession to win them that first round of the overtime. And now, Envy on another buy here. Wow, the scoreboard is completely screwed. Unless Sixer is the best player of all time. We can see now Envy do have the buy, but again, low on money, so scary, scary stuff for Envy. Could they be throwing away another chance to take the series? Cadian already getting the opening on towards XMS. We didn't quite see it, but finally, his AWP is paying off. No one else from Envy willing to PK main now that Cadian has already picked up a kill. Valda goes through with a flash. He's looking to push through. Sixer just on the other side of that smoke. Peeks out straight into the molly, and Valda's going to kill him with it. What a weird decision from Sixer there. Gives Heroic such a big advantage in the round. And now Envy could be throwing away three more map points here. As the flash goes through, Envy still in a 3v5 with Valda low on health, so... I guess it's not all over yet. However, Nico takes out Happy, and now all of a sudden in a 2v5, I think this round is pretty much gone. Scream and RPK both gambling towards the A site. You can see both of them just sitting on the bomb train. However, it looks like Heroic do have some info that it's a few players towards A. RPK sure takes down Nico, but who the hell cares when you can see Snappy and the rest of Heroic running through to the B site. And they will plant it easily here. And Heroic should be taking this round all day, every day from now on. I don't see any way RPK and Scream can retake here. Looks like Scream pushes up to take the AWP, does recover it in time. And Envy will be forced to try and clutch it through in their final round here. We will be seeing it go to 18-17. If Heroic win this next round, we'll be going to a second overtime. Meanwhile, if Envy win it, they will win the entire series, but they might not have the best buy on their side. Looks like Heroic don't want to let them save here. Of course, they have quite a lot of money. Scream does get one with the AWP. He's going to try and save it. He runs through the smoke. Smart play from Scream. I think he's going to survive. And indeed he does. Nicely done from Scheme to at least save the AWP, but you can see here, that's pretty much the only gun Envy are going to have coming into this round. Will Scream keep it? Nope, he drops it over to Sixer. So a lot of trust in towards Sixer for this round. You can see the rest of Envy do have decent weaponry. I guess it's a better buy than I thought, but it's still nothing compared to Heroic's buy. You can see Sixer just holding the A main cross right now. Meanwhile, the rest of Heroic are slowly going up towards the B site. They certainly aren't committed to the B site just yet, but if they do push towards it, it will be a good decision with Sixer's AWP still being towards A right now. The push down towards A ramp could be going on early into the round. The good flash allows them to take down RPK. Now there's just one player on towards the site. Happy gets a dink, but it's not good enough for the kill. Heroic run over the B site, and it's looking like we should be going to a second overtime here. Moddy takes down the first. XMS, Scream, the only two players left. XMS stuck in an awkward position here on the other side of the connector. Does he know Snappy is there? He's just going to walk past him. This is so awkward from both players. Kaden eventually takes down XMS. And Scream has to try and win a 1v5 to keep Envy's chances of winning alive, but he doesn't manage to do it. And we will be going to a second overtime. What is happening in this game? So many series points for Envy, but they just can't quite convert them. As we will be seeing if either team can close it out in the second overtime here. Envy so far, I believe, have had 8 chances to win outright. They've had 8 rounds where they've been 1 round away from winning the entire thing, and they just can't quite pull it off right now. You know, at least they're giving themselves the chances to win it, but still, unfortunately, when push comes to shove, they just can't seem to get over the line, you know? They get all the way to the end, they see the finish, it's so close, and then they just end up tripping themselves up. We will, however, be seeing the start of the second overtime here. Happy this time, picking up the AWP. It's not like he had a good spawn or anything, so I guess that might be a call from him, or it might be a call from Sixer, who knows, but Sixer, who has been the primary AWP, not picking it up this time. Meanwhile, Heroic are still staying strong with Kadian on the AWP. They still believe in their primary AWP, which I think you have to do. It looks like, again, Heroic might go for a quick B play here. It worked out last round, however, to do it again is pretty risky. You can see the push coming through here. It's Snappy already pushing through on towards the site. It's Kadian, though, who manages to finish off the kill. And again, Heroic take the B site with ease. Now they have to play it post-plant. Envy do get one back with help from Sixer. He does take himself down very low in the process, though. There's Happy with his AWP getting a kill. However, Kadian trades one back with his own AWP. 3v3 now. However, Heroic are in pretty good positions to stop anything post-plant here. And look at that. Snappy peeks out and takes off Happy's head clean as you like. The Sixer and Scream have to try and clutch it 2v3. There's already Sixer getting taken down. Scream in a 1v3. Kadian sure is low, but Nico is still on full health. And that is the man he comes up against and loses to in the duel. As Heroic, for the first time in a while, take the lead here on this map. We will be seeing again Envy on a buy, and wow, 2 AWPs. Big investment from Envy. If they lose this round, they will be pretty screwed in terms of money. So this is a big round for Envy. Meanwhile, Kadian, of course, still with a single AWP for the T side. Valder pushing out aggressively, gets blinded up. XMS on the other side of the smoke, but Valder somehow must have spotted a gap there. The 2 AWPs, though, working wonders so far. Sixer and Scream both pick up a kill each. Valder pushing through aggressively. Scream gets taken down, but it's still a 3v3. Definitely doable. Sixer is up on towards Green Chain. Valder doesn't realize he's still up there. Oh no! They do take him down, and now it should be in favor of Heroic here. This is such an awkward fight. RPK somehow gets 2! And now it's all up to Valder to try and hold off the bomb. Happy, though, will tap it. He's not got the kit. Valder surely will be pushing through. Valder wins it. For some reason, Happy tries to stick the bomb. It doesn't work out. And Heroic do manage to pull through the round win off of the back of Valder's 4 kills. But how the hell did RPK get 2 kills in that spot? He gave Envy a real good shot at winning that round. And Happy just can't quite manage to pull it through for some reason. Sticking the defuse. Crazy rounds back and forth throughout this game. We will be seeing now Envy on a pretty awful buy. See what they choose to do. Quick flash over towards A. Cadian going aggressive with the AWP, but it's actually Moddy who's going even more aggressive to pick up the first AK kill. In fact, it's two for Moddy right now. Heroic could be getting a perfect T-half on overtime here. They could be getting all three rounds. And that would put them in a great position to win the map and the series here. Three players left for Envy to try and clutch it, but Snappy already gets one. There's another, and it will just be Sixer versus the world, but no. Again, Sixer is not Superman either. He gets taken down. And Heroic just have to win one out of three CT side rounds here to win the entire map. I mean, you would assume Heroic would surely be able to win one round on CT side out of three in overtime, but honestly, the way this game has been going, I feel like we're almost guaranteed to go to another overtime. It just feels like it's that sort of game, you know? We will be restarting straight away into the second half. Let's see what Heroic choose to do in terms of AWPs. I'm assuming it would just be Cadian on the AWP. Although, ooh, Snappy's bought it. This is a bit of a switch up from Heroic. Meanwhile, of course, Envy just Sixer buying the AWP, which is to be expected. But Heroic decide to go for a double AWP setup of their own. That's kind of risky. It does cost a lot of money, so if they lose the first two rounds, they will definitely be very poor heading into the last one. Flashes over the top here. There's Sixer's AWP towards A main, trying to get an early pick in the round. Don't worry, this is not your stream lagging. This is a game, as we see. Heroic just sitting back passively to start the round, as are Envy. Both teams trying to play it slowly. Of course, any mistake at this stage could be fatal. In the double overtime here, Moddy, I'm pretty surprised he just kind of stands out in the open with the smoke out there. Like, if Scream peeks and takes his head off, that's pretty brutal. Doesn't get punished for it this time, though. As we will be seeing a very, very slow round indeed so far still. 1 minute, 9 seconds left on the clock for Envy, but no one's even attempted to take a fight from Envy's side so far. You can see a couple of mollies, a couple of smokes going through. Happy going for a bit of aggression early on into the round here, and he could be going for a fight, but actually loses out instantly to Moddy, who goes straight for the dink. Look at that, the two AWPs already doing wonders. The double AWP setup working beautifully. We will be seeing Scream and Sixer left in a 2v4 to try and clutch it through for Envy. Can they pull it off to keep their team alive here? Scream trying to push through, can't quite find an angle yet. Sixer, meanwhile, nowhere near. The flash goes through, Scream does manage to dodge it. Sixer's there to help him out. Envy are making this one doable all of a sudden. Valda takes a 1v1 fight that wasn't necessary, and if Envy can manage to find some 1v1 duels against Heroic, it's doable. With 18 seconds left, Sixer gets another kill. 16 seconds now, they have to commit to a site. They're deciding to go towards A. The Molotov going in. Could Envy clutch this one off the back of Sixer? The AWP is doing good work. Why is Scream choosing to plant there? Oh my god, that could lose them the game. Sixer somehow hits the shot, but there's no time. It's over. Nico runs away, and that makes the difference. Why did Scream choose to plant on that side of the train? That's just cost them the game. Like, I just don't see any reason for it. They haven't clear connector. There's no point. Just plant for pop. That's insane. I honestly don't know what I've just witnessed, but holy crap, what a game. So back and forth. Envy end up being very disappointed at the end of it, you would think. Heroic managed to pull off an insane comeback, though. Let's give it up to Heroic, to be fair. 15-10 down in regulation, they come back, they take it to overtime. 18-15 down in overtime, they win the three rounds in a row to take it to the second overtime. And they don't make the same mistake that they did earlier, you know. They're not going to let